I just got a package from a company called Potato Semiconductor. That has to be the best name for a company ever. Potato specializes in taking old-school 74 series logic chips from the 1970s and updating the designs so that they can work at frequencies of 1 GHz and beyond. In this video, I'm going to have fun with their 1.125 GHz hex inverter IC. I want to see if I can use it to build a high-frequency ring oscillator. Normally when you make a ring oscillator, you'd have a resistor and a capacitor between each stage to slow down the transitions between high and low, and thereby setting the oscillation frequency. But with this chip, the 4 picofarad input capacitance on each inverter is double the ideal 2 picofarad load you would have on the output. And since each inverter output will have a certain series impedance, I'm just going to connect 3 inverters back to back. Any additional capacitance would just slow things down. Here's a quick shot of the deadbug soldering job. It's literally just some capacitors across the power pins, then I have 3 inverters soldered in series. I probed the output with my oscilloscope and I got around 375 MHz. Not bad for 74 series logic. Now, doing this measurement with my oscilloscope is probably not the best idea, partly because I've only got 500 MHz bandwidth, but also my oscilloscope probe puts a relatively large 11 picofarad load on the oscillator, which will slow things down. So I'm going to try probing the oscillator with a spectrum analyzer instead. The fundamental frequency is 397 MHz. So I guess the oscilloscope wasn't the major problem here. I'm just limited by the input capacitance and the propagation delay of each inverter. I'm sure the fact that it's a terribly constructed circuit doesn't help either. The third harmonic at 1.19 GHz is pretty significant, so this would make a decent candidate for a frequency multiplier circuit. And I think it's funny that there are harmonics all the way up to 2.7 GHz and beyond. If you took the time to tweak the circuit, you could make a short-range Bluetooth jammer. And no, I'm not going to tell you how to do that. The oscillator is exactly as unstable as you'd expect, dancing around all over the place. The circuit draws a surprising 0.28 watts of power, which is enough to heat the chip up over 60 degrees C. I found that blowing on the hot potato chip was enough to speed it up by several megahertz. In conclusion, electronics is fun, and naming your company after a dad joke is a great idea.